Page 23. Misconceptions. There are some who take delight in making the Buddha a non-human. They quote a passage from the Anguttara Nikaya, number 2, 37 page, mistranslate it and misunderstand it. The story goes thus. Once the Buddha was seated under a tree in meditative pose, his senses calmed, his mind quiet, and attained to supreme control and serenity. Then a Brahmin, Donna by name, approached the Buddha and asked, "Sir, will you be a god, a deva?" "No, Brahmin." "Sir, will you be a heavenly angel, a gandhaba?" "No, Brahmin." "Sir, will you be a demon, a yakka?" "No, Brahmin." "Sir, will you be a human being, a manusa?" "No, Brahmin." "Then, sir, what indeed will you be?" Now understand the Buddha's reply carefully. "Brahmin, whatever defilements there be owing to the presence of which a person may be identified as a god or a heavenly angel or a demon or a human being, all these defilements in me are abandoned, cut off at the root, made like a palm tree stump, done away with, and are no more subject to future arising. Just as Brahmin, a blue or red or white lotus born in water, grows in water and stands up above the water untouched by it, so too I, who was born in the world and grew up in the world, have transcended the world, and I live untouched by the world. Remember me as one who is enlightened." What the Buddha said was that he is not a god or heavenly angel or a demon or a human being full of defilements. From the above, it is clear that the Buddha wanted the Brahmin to know that he was not a human being with defilements. He did not want the Brahmin to put him into any of those categories. The Buddha was in the world, but not of the world. This is clear from the simile of the lotus. Hasty critics, however, rush to a wrong conclusion and want others to believe that the Buddha was not a human being. In the Anguttara Nikaya, number 1, page 22, there is a clear instance in which the Buddha categorically declared that he was a human being. "Monks, there is one person, Pugala, whose birth into this world is for the welfare and happiness of many. Out of compassion for the world, for the gain and welfare and happiness of the gods, and humanity. Who is this one person? It is the Tathagata, who is the consummate one, Arahat, a supremely enlightened one, Sammasambuddha. Monks, one person born into this world is an extraordinary man, a marvelous man. Not the Pali word manusa, a human being. Yes, the Buddha was a human being, but not just another man. He was a marvelous man. The Buddhist texts say that the Bodhisattva, as he was known before he became the Buddha, was in the Tushita heaven, Devaloka, but came down to the human world to be born as a human being. His parents, King Suddhodana and Queen Mahamaya, were human beings. The Bodhisattva was born as a man, attained enlightenment, Buddhahood, as a man, and finally passed away into Parinirvana as a man. Even after his supreme enlightenment, he did not call himself a god or Brahma or any supernatural being, but an extraordinary man. Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, a Hindu, stepped into the tenets of the Vedas and Vedanta, says that Buddhism is an offshoot of Hinduism, and even goes to the extent of calling the Buddha a Hindu. He writes, "The Buddha did not feel that he was announcing a new religion. He was born, grew up, and died a Hindu. He was restating with a new emphasis the ancient ideals of the Indo-Aryan civilization. But the Buddha himself declares that his teachings was a revelation of truths discovered by himself, not known to his contemporaries, not inherited from past tradition. Thus, in his very first sermon, referring to the Four Noble Truths, he said, 'Monks, with a thought, this is the noble truth of suffering. This is its cause. This is its cessation. This is the way leading to its cessation. There arose in me vision, knowledge, wisdom, insight, and light concerning things unheard before.'" Again, while making clear to his disciples the difference between a fully enlightened one and the arhats, the consummate ones, the Buddha says, "The Tathagata, O disciples, while being an arhat, is fully enlightened. It is he who proclaims a way not proclaimed before. He is the knower of a way, who understands a way, who is skilled in a way." And now his disciples are wayfarers who follow in his footsteps. The ancient way the Buddha refers to is the Noble Eightfold Path and is not any ideals of the Indo-Aryan civilizations, as Dr. Ruanda Krishnan imagines. However, referring to the Buddha, Mahatma Gandhi, the architect of Indian independence, says, "By his immense sacrifice, by his great renunciation, and by the immaculate purity of his life, he left an indelible impress upon Hinduism, and Hinduism owes an eternal debt of gratitude to that great teacher." This is the end at page 27.